a bit high, I think. It's a bit high. I used to remember when we didn't have to use all this technology. I'm a real dinosaur. And in Malaysia, I used a handphone, I used a Nokia. How many people, when was the last time you saw a Nokia? Yeah, I tell my friends, I'm not smart enough for a smartphone. So I use the dinosaur model. Yes. So, okay, so we'll take the five precepts and we'll just chant together. Namo tassa bhagavato arahato samma sambuddhassa. Namo tassa bhagavato arahato samma sambuddhassa. Namo tassa bhagavato arahato samma sambuddhassa. Buddham saranam gacchami. Dhammam saranam gacchami. Sangham saranam gacchami. Dutiyampi Buddham saranam gacchami. Dutiyampi Dhammam saranam gacchami. Dutiyampi Sangham saranam gacchami. Tatiyampi Buddham saranam gacchami. Tatiyampi Dhammam saranam gacchami. Tatiyampi Sangham saranam gacchami. Panatipata veramani sikkhapadam samadhiyami. Adinadana veramani sikkhapadam samadhiyami. Muskame sumichachara veramani sikkhapadam samadhiyami. Musavada veramani sikkhapada samadhiyami. Suramereya majapamadatana veramani sikkhapada samadhiyami. Sadhu, sadhu, sadhu. So welcome to a day of mindfulness. And as you know, mindfulness is a very beneficial practice. And as our lives get faster, more stressful, the benefits of mindfulness is getting more and more important. And especially these days with the coronavirus situation. And I try to suggest to people, try to watch as little news as possible. Because the more news you watch, you become more anxious, more afraid. Because I remember in 2003 when they had the SARS virus crisis, because I was in Toronto at the time, and two of the infected cases, which began in Hong Kong, in a hotel in Hong Kong, although the virus came from Guangdong, two of the infected cases went directly to Toronto. Because, you know, we have many Hong Kong people in Toronto and Vancouver. And those two infected cases infected a few more, but they were quickly contained and quarantined. at a hospital in the east end of Toronto, an area called Scarborough. But the media created so much fear, so much anxiety. And in North America, the media is really strong, both in Canada, United States. And they created so much fear, what we call media hype, that all summer activities were canceled that summer of 2003. Because, you know, in cold countries, there are more activities in the summer than in the winter, but everything was canceled. Except for one Tibetan group, very interesting. Only one Tibetan group had their conferences. Very interesting. So you can really see the power of the media. And you know, there's more fear and anxiety in Singapore compared to Malaysia. Because, as you know, it's a small place, it's very compact. People are more stressful by nature. And of course, there's more media coverage. So there's more anxiety there. And some people went, they panicked and did a lot of shopping. You may have seen it on the media. They went buying and buying like crazy. You know, rice, noodles, and so on. So anyhow, let us begin with the dynamic meditation. Some of you are familiar with it. And it's a very easy practice. I learned it in Thailand many years ago, although it's originally from Laos, the country of Laos. And this is a good practice, not only for beginners, but for people with experience, myself included. Because, you know, sometimes you try to meditate, but for some reason you just can't focus your mind. This happens to all of us. So this practice is very useful if you can't focus your mind. And of course, when we have too much mental activity, when we're thinking too much, worrying, obsessing, regretting, and so on. So just place your palms on your knees. And the video is on YouTube. I can give you the link afterwards. Okay. And you're going to start with the right hand, and you raise the right palm on the edge like this, lifting slowly to the stomach. Feel your hand touching the stomach area, then left palm up, lifting to the stomach. Be aware of your hand touching the other hand. And keep your hands very loose, very relaxed, not tight. Then right hand up to the chest, the right hand. Be aware of the touch in the chest area. Out, down. Feel the touch on the knee, then palm down. Left hand up, touching, out, down and down. Right palm. Stomach. Left. Right. Left. Right, left, right, left, right. Thank you. So once you learn the movements, you can just look down, or you can close your eyes. And you're aware of each movement, and when the hand touches the body. So this really brings you easily into the present moment. And as we do this, be aware of any thoughts which arise in the mind. Just like when you're doing mindful breathing. Just be aware of thoughts. And just come back to the hand movements and the touch. So in this way, you let go. Let go of unnecessary thinking and come back to present moment. Okay. So later on this afternoon, if you're feeling a bit sleepy or you're losing focus, you can just do this. Do this for a few minutes and you can open your eyes. And of course, if you meet anyone who's worrying too much about something, you can share this practice with them. It's very useful. Is there anyone who is new to mindful breathing? Anyone who's new? Okay. Okay. So if you're new, the focus is here. Just feel the body breathing, you know, rising, falling, or expanding, contracting. So that is your focus, just the whole body here. Now, to help focus the mind, because it is natural for the mind to wander away. As you breathe in, just say in your mind, in. As you breathe out, just say in your mind, out. In, out, in, out. So the important thing in this practice is patience. Being patient with the wandering mind. Because it is natural for the mind to wander away. You know, memories. Or maybe you're thinking about what you're going to do later this evening, or tomorrow, or next week. So just be patient with the wandering mind. And also, you don't try to control the mind. You don't try to achieve something. When the mind wanders away, just be aware it's wandering away and gently bring your attention back to in, out, in, out. if you're feeling sleepy, you can open your eyes and do the hand movements, the dynamic hand movements.
So you can shift your legs and just be aware of the sensation, cramping sensation, tingling sensation. So be aware of the changing nature of these sensations. See how they change, how they go away. Then when you're ready, you can slowly stand. Just take your time, just slowly stand. From side to side if you wish. Just slowly, and be aware of your feet on the floor. Be aware of in-breath, out-breath, and your feet on the floor. Be aware of in-breath, out-breath, and your feet on the floor. Okay, and just put your cushions to the side, and we can do some mindful walking. Just put your cushions to the side somewhere.